Pervert Alert, Democrat John Conyers accused of hosting staff meeting in underwear, harassing DC lawyer. After the Harvey Weinstein scandal broke national headlines, dozens of other women began exposing the truth about Hollywood's elite and their perverted obsessions. Unfortunately, however, it didn't stop there, and as we've just recently found out, this sexual harassment epidemic includes a vast swathe of the Democratic Party. Democrats were the party that endorsed racism, the KKK, and have been responsible for keeping the black community in poverty thanks to years of victimization and welfare handouts. It should come as no surprise then, that after intense investigations were launched, their party has been found to be littered with perverts. According to a former key staffer, Representative John Conyers of Michigan is exactly that, a pervert. While he may not have the fame or influence that Harvey Weinstein had, Melanie Sloan, a high-ranking lawyer who worked with various politicians, has just dropped a bombshell about his alleged sexual harassment. Fox News reports. No one had to guess whether Representative John Conyers wore boxers or briefs, according to a former key staffer, who said the embattled Michigan lawmaker once called her into a meeting while sporting only his skivvies. Melanie Sloan, a lawyer who worked with Conyers on the House Judiciary Committee, said she was called up to the long-serving congressman's office to discuss an issue only to find him walking around in his underwear. While some have dismissed Sloan's accusations as mere conjecture, or grabs for money, she's actually the third woman who's accused Conyers of such inappropriate behavior. "It made me increasingly anxious and depressed about going to work every day," she said, adding that there was no way to fix it. Despite being a well-known DC lawyer, she says that there was no mechanism she could use, and no person she could go to. She worked as Democratic counsel on the House Judiciary Committee in the 1990s, and while it's not exactly clear when this bizarre encounter with Conyers occurred, she's adamant that it's the truth. During her time working for this perverted Democrat, she claims that Conyers was extremely verbally abusive. He often screamed at her, fired her and then rehired her, criticized her for not wearing sexy enough clothing, and even ordered her to babysit one of his children. While those revelations came out earlier this week, word of Conyers, who was first elected to Congress in 1964, taking a meeting in his underwear came this week in a Detroit Free Press article. Though Sloan maintains Conyers did not sexually assault her, she told the Detroit Free Press that his constant stream of abuse was difficult to handle and it was certainly damaging to my self-respect and self-esteem. Conyers' hometown newspaper earlier this week called for his resignation in the wake of sexual harassment allegations against him as well as a questionable payout to one alleged victim. Conyers is accused of using taxpayer dollars to settle a claim in secret, after a former staff reportedly claimed she was fired for rejecting his advances. In a scathing editorial published late Tuesday, the Detroit Free Press demanded the Democrat step down immediately. The paper called Conyers' actions the kind of behavior that can never be tolerated in a public official, much less an elected representative of the people. He should resign his position and allow the investigation into his behavior to unfold without the threat that it would render him, and the people he now represents, effectively voiceless, the board wrote. BuzzFeed published a story on Monday claiming that Conyers paid off a staffer in 2015 to keep her mouth shut about the abuse which went on behind closed doors. She claims she was dismissed because she didn't succumb to his sexual advances, and it seems that we're starting to see a pattern here. Conyers later acknowledged in a statement that he did in fact pay this accuser a lump sum of money, reportedly $27,000, but has still insisted that he's innocent and did not sexually harass anyone. "I expressly and vehemently denied the allegations made against me, and continue to do so," Conyers, who's a 53-year veteran of Congress, said. "My office resolved the allegations, with an express denial of liability, to save all involved from the rigors of protracted litigation. That should not be lost in the narrative," he added. "Funny how that works, though. Most of the time you don't pay someone off unless they actually have evidence that can end you." But the Detroit Free Press, which described Conyers as an undisputed hero of the civil rights movement, took issue with how Conyers' office chose to handle the issue. After the alleged victim made a formal complaint through Congress Office of Compliance, Conyers' office reportedly pushed to handle the situation on its own. If the woman dropped her complaint, signed a legal document saying Conyers had done nothing wrong and promised not to make any additional claims against him, she would be rehired as a temporary no-show employee and paid $27,111.75 for 3 months, according to reports. The accuser agreed to the terms. Conyers' office defended the agreement as a way to avoid litigation, though House ethics rules bar lawmakers from keeping an employee on the payroll who isn't doing anything. A House member can't retain an employee who isn't performing work commensurate with the pay, and regardless, can't give back pay for work that stretches further than a month, the editorial board wrote. While acknowledging that payoffs happen in the private sector, the board said it should never, ever happen where public dollars, and public accountability, are concerned. Calling it a public betrayal, the board wrote it's impossible to know how often the practice takes place in Congress but added Conyers should have known better. Even though resigning would end his otherwise stellar career, the paper wrote that it's the appropriate consequence for the stunning subterfuge his office has indulged here, and a needed warning to other members of Congress that this can never be tolerated. The House Ethics Committee announced Tuesday it has opened an investigation into the matter. As more and more Democrats are now being exposed for the perverts they are, many are wondering who will be at the helm of their ship for the election of 2020. With Hillary Clinton having lost such a massive battle against President Donald Trump, and with more scandals coming out by the hour, it seems that it's only a matter of time before the DNC collapses.